Hello guys, good evening. Let's start with the weekly analysis. So starting with the Indian market, I've opened the Nifty chart. And if you notice the way the last week candle has closed, it has clearly engulfed the previous candle, if you notice, and it's showing that market can do a major pullback. So long-term perspective is that it has a possibility that it can do a pullback till here, because this was the breakout level. So you can expect Indian market to fall down at a very deep level, provided it breaks its own previous support. Like this was the previous swing high. If the candle closed below that, then this will be the next support market would be looking to fall at, and then accordingly. So we can also discuss the same on the daily chart. See, if you notice, this is a 30 moving average, which I personally use. And currently, since the candle has closed below the 30 period moving average, it is expected to fall down further. And this will be the first level. And see, the previous trend line which I had drawn, it's almost coinciding with the moving average. So this is the area which you can expect it to fall, provided once this level is broken. So you can expect Nifty to do a major pullback. And see, this is the trend line. So this is the first level. I'm expecting market to come down till this level. If it breaks below, then it can fall down further, which is till this level. So you can expect a deep level of pullback. So it's advisable that not to be on the buying side of Nifty. Yes, if you trade options and all, you can be on the short side. You can short it. And actually, current price is also very good to short. And see, this is, if you get a bearish candle confirmation here, you can be on the sell side. Yesterday, it clearly gave a confirmation once when it did a breakout of this minor level. If I draw a proper support resistance level here, see, this was a support resistance turned into support. It did a breakout, minor pullback, and it clearly gave a confirmation for sell. If you haven't sold till now, then you can again sell it at the current price and it looks good. And you can target up till this level. So I am clearly bearish for this week. I'm not saying that the trend has changed or something, because that confirmation is still not there. But yes, I'm expecting a major pullback to happen. If this level breaks, then you can expect even deeper pullback. So this is the first level where I'm expecting 14,000, around level 14,200, somewhere around that level. You can expect Nifty to fall down and you can short and make money on towards the sell side. Same if I open the Bank Nifty chart, the weekly time frame. See, there was a clear rejection last week. The candle has clearly rejected it. And I'm expecting it to fall down till this level. I'll remove this one. If you notice this trend line, this was a resistance. Breakout was clearly happened. Now, this is more of a pullback if market pullbacks still here and then picks up again. So it would, deciding factor will be somewhere around here. If we get a bearish close, then market would continue to be on the downside. If we get a rejection like a bullish pin bar or something, then we would it would be like a breakout, pullback, candle, bullish candlestick confirmation, and then we'll again switch to buy. But I would not buy till the time I'm not getting any confirmation at this level, which means clearly I'm expecting to market to fall down up till this area. So again, Nifty, Bank Nifty, clearly on the sell side. So that's why I'm not discussing a lot many stocks here, because those mainly we look for if you're trading on cash market, mainly for buying the stocks and all. So currently, I would not suggest you to enter at the current prices. Wait for the market to come down till this level and then decide. If market forms like a bullish pin bar or a bullish confirmation, then you can be on the buying side. So this is the analysis for Nifty and Bank Nifty for this week. Now moving to Forex market. So Forex market, you can see dollar index chart here. First thing, that's what we analyze. So dollar index is clearly, this is a fall. Market is doing the pullback. Again, a deeper fall, again a pullback. Again, market, see, once it breaks this level, it will be a clear confirmation that the market is looking to go down further. So it's at a sensitive level, though, yeah, the way the candles are forming and everything, it's looking bearish. But be careful, market is currently at a very strong previous support where market had taken a support previously. If this breaks, then you can expect a very deep fall again, which would be somewhere around till, just a second, let me clone it. Yeah, so then you can expect the market to fall up till this level, which is, yeah, next level of fall, because that was the previous level which was getting respected. After this next level, what you can expect if market breaks further down, then it is this support level. So if you notice, these are the levels where market is getting respected continuously. Previously also, it was following the same level. See here. Right. So minor consolidation, it did a breakout. Again, if this did a breakout, then you can be on the sell side till this level. So dollar index, yes, momentum wise is looking like a sell. It's just that the last time, see, it picked up from here a little. So current price, just be a little careful. Wait for it to break below. Don't enter at the current price. If you already have a sell, you can definitely hold on. But you don't enter at the current price. Let it either break or let it give you a better entry to enter for a sell. Okay. So that's about dollar. So gold and silver, since dollar is bearish, so gold automatically becomes more on the upside. Because it has an inverse correlation. Also, it is at a support level. So if you notice, this is the resistance and this is the support area. You can draw it accordingly. See, every time lows are also getting lower, highs are getting lower again. This is more of a wedge formation. And since it's looking to meet together eventually, so falling wedge, generally the breakout happens on the upside. But we again wait for the breakout. So when it is at the support, you can be on the buying side and target till here. But since it's a falling wedge, there's a higher possibility that the breakout should happen on the upside. And if this breakout happens on the upside, then dollar index will continue to be on the downside. It has a clear inverse correlation. That's a long-term view for this week. It's, if it's at the support, you can buy and target up till this level of 1860, 1858. So it is looking strong till there, but it has been consolidating from a long period of time. So once it does the breakout, then be towards the trend side. But till then, you can buy at the support, sell at the resistance. That's what we can do. Like dollar is at a sensitive phase, might take a support there. Likewise, if it takes a support in dollar, it starts going up, then you can expect gold to fall down. So a complete inverse correlation. If dollar goes up, gold falls down. If dollar goes down, gold goes up. So it's a clear inverse correlation. So for now, since dollar is indicating for sell, and if you already have a sell trade, other currencies, you can clearly figure out that it's indicating for buy, which means Euro, USD, see, right? Clear confirmation, you can extend your trend line. It will give you even better clarity. So you can be on the buy side targeting till this level. Targeting this resistance level. Once it breaks, if dollar continues to fall down, once it breaks, you can continue to be on the upside. So since dollar is on the sell side, so every other major pairs, Euro USD buy, New Zealand USD will also see last week candle closing is bullish. Even GBP USD, see, it has been going up, and this is the target with what you can expect for GBP to go up till there. Strongly bullish here. If you will notice, AUD, USD also strongly bullish, because dollar, whenever dollar has a trend, you will see all major pairs also having the same trend. USD CAD, since dollar here is the first pair, dollar is falling down, so USD CAD also has a fall. So since we are discussing about CAD, we can check oil chart as well. So oil clearly is looking to go up, though it formed a rejection last week, but it is continuing the momentum on the upside. Let's check for WTI. There would be more data then. Yeah. So this one is a chart what we can check upon. So it is clearly going up, though there was a rejection, if you notice, but this week, this was the last week, so again market can get rejected from here. So this is yesterday's and today's move which has happened. So again it is at the resistance, so this candle does not confirm that market is strongly bullish, because this candle will close by this week end. So rely more on the candle closes. If you can be on the weekly side and daily candles, and accordingly you can take the confirmation and be on the direction side. But I would say be careful at this level of oil, because see, last time also it got rejected. Again, you can expect that market rejects. If it closes above, then you can have the next level at around this area. This level of around 70, you can expect, but market has to close and break this level. It has gone up, could be a part of the pullback as well. It is just a Monday and today's Tuesday's move. So that's about oil. What you can do is you can be on the smaller time frame, 4-hourly or daily, or whichever smaller time frame you are trading. And then you can trade once you have a confirmation in the higher time frame. So let's say if you get a bearish candle close, which means market can again turn from here and go up till the next support level, which is this. So you can trade in between the range. That's what you can do till the time weekly close is not happening. So this is a channel how last week also market got rejected, and that's how we had a pin bar on a weekly time frame. Again, you can expect the same thing. If it breaks above, then you can go with breakout pullback on the upside. If you get a bearish engulfing or something closing like this, then you can be on the sell side targeting till this level. So that's how you can trade in between the range till the time you are not getting the weekly close confirmation. So that's about US oil here. So this is the analysis for this week. One trade setup of this chart which I have is GBP-NCD, which is a good setup. And so if you notice, just now the pullback is happening. So setup is ready. That's why I wanted to discuss this. But you have to wait for the entry. So it's a very strong breakout pullback setup. Okay. So see, it is a strong support. Breakout has happened, pullback has happened. And once you get a candle confirmation on a smaller time frame, just now the pullback is happening, which is good. Pullback happens, the smaller the risk we will have, the more aggressive entry we will get. But be very careful around this level. You might get a good sell confirmation where you can target up till the next support. So this is one setup which I'm keeping an eye on, because this is a very strong breakout pullback setup where 200 moving average is also coinciding at the same level. So also if you want, you can draw your Fibonacci if you use the Fibo level. From high to low, and see it's exactly rejecting 23.6 level. So it's a very strong confluence setup, and you can accordingly trade once you get an entry confirmation on a smaller time frame. So that's the setups for this week. Indian market, I haven't discussed much stocks this week, because I'm clearly expecting that the market should fall a little, do a major pullback, and then we would have better prices to enter. So that's it for this week. Patiently wait for your strategies to form, your strategy setups to come, and you should always trade as per your strategy. We'll meet again next week. Next week, I'll be posting the video on Monday itself. So see you guys next week. Bye-bye. Take care.